It looks like any other ordinary activity that these two women are participating in. But on a closer look, they are holding seeds of maize and sorghum as they collect and weave dry grass, dry banana leaves and sticks. The women wearing similar African print clothes are Lanyero Christine and Nyega Rose. They explain that they are creating a unique, actually traditional cocoon used for the preservation of seeds for the planting season.
It stores the different types of seeds that the Acholi people plant, and when rains return, you pick the seeds for planting.
These women belong to the Kekal Kwaro Acholi Cultural Institution. They are here to reawaken the people about the traditional ways that they actually used to preserve seeds and food in the fight against food scarcity and famine.
Part of it is it's for keeping seeds or crops, and that's how it used to be done. And our job is to revive it, to resuscitate it. And in Guru City here, you don't see these structures anymore. It's not there. It has been overtaken by concrete, cement, you know, modern technology things. Good, but also there is a negative.
Bochingo can be traced back to the early Acholi community that resided in Bahel Ghazal region of South Sudan. Nyega Rose is proud and luxurious about the beautiful Acholi culture. As she explains to us about the Bochingo, she sips cold water from her gourd.
We brought Bokongor here because we have seen culture things here. We are from the place of Acholi paramount chief.
The elongated chrysalis is tied to a dry stick next to the granary, which is locally known as Dero. And it stands high above the ground.
Boch, my chiel, you make a little thought.
Boch, number one, is important to keep away wood lice. It does not eat up the seed, dry seed, which are supposed to be kept for the rain season. When it rains, the seed or what you've kept inside does not get wet. Come on, place it down underneath.
Yes.
Then you lift it like that, you can see, to hold it up. Then go in and pick what you
need. Bochingo protects the seeds from insects, pests, and rainwater. Okema Richard, who specializes in building traditional granaries, adds that thieves do not steal food and seeds kept in Bochingo and Dero in fear of curses.
A small site like this one, most cases for sesame seed or millet, because it's small size. The neighbor over there, the bigger size is for sorghum, and cowpeas, beans, and some other small seeds.
The construction of Bochingo and Dero has become a source of knowledge to the younger generation who visit Tax Art Center in Gulu City.
As you can see, I came to know just recently. It's a hard thing to see when you move around, you can't easily get. So bringing it here, if someone comes from some like if a visitor comes and see and ask, and if explained well, I think even people can again come back to that.
And there is an increased need to create awareness about the traditional ways that Africans naturally fought famine and fed their families for generations.
Lobbying for any goodwill person outside there to come and be partnership with us, so that we can really share this beautiful culture we have got here, so it does not die.
Today, people keep seeds in polythene bags, buckets, and other items which expose the seeds to pests and rot. But the Bochingo stands the test of time.
Here at Tax Center, the Bochingo and the Dero have got a lot of attention from passerby. It is now up to the parents and the cultural leaders to teach the young generation about the different ways that we Africans preserved food. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.